darling. How are you this evening? Good. Are you ready for your dermatologist exam? Good. Okay, why don't you take a seat? Let's get started. All right. Thank you for checking in. I appreciate that. Let me just type in these last little notes. Do you have any other extra concerns that you'd like to talk to me about before we begin? Okay. Could you go ahead and show me? Right here. Okay. And how long has that been there? Okay. Great. You'd like me to remove that for you? No problem. Has it gotten any bigger or changed in color or anything? Okay. Well, I can definitely look at that. Okay. No problem. And then if you'd like, we can do a little biopsy of it, okay? Then we could tell you if there's anything extra to worry about. What about these other ones that you have? Are you concerned about those at all? No, there is one about. Okay. Let me just look real quick. Okay. And has that changed in size or color? Okay, great. Well, I have, you don't have to worry about any pain for those, okay? I have numbing cream, okay? And probably in just a few minutes, we'll probably just go ahead and start putting that on so we can go ahead and start working until we get to the actual removal, okay? So then I'd be able to look through your scalp a little bit more and your face and ears and everything, okay? Okay. So let me go ahead and get started. Go ahead and put some gloves on. How are you today? Yeah, no, I bet. First, just going to do an overall visual, okay? Just so I can maybe see. Actually, let me go ahead and just take my light here. Just going to see if there's on your skin, on any places that I need to just kind of pinpoint, maybe. Okay. Do you have any areas that are actually painful or sensitive? Okay. Definitely with seasons changing. Okay. And what about your ears? I'll do a little more of a... We're gonna do in-depth kind of exams for that, but is there anything that stands out? Really, thank you for wearing a short sleeve as well. So I need to look on your arms and your hands. No problem. And what was the main reason that you were coming in today? Just the mole removal mainly, okay. Well, that's really good, because I'd like definitely to see if there's any other places that we need to be aware of, okay? Alright, thank you. So I want to go ahead and start on your scalp and then kind of just work my way down, okay? And maybe after we get about to your neck, I'll go ahead and start putting that cream on there. There should maybe only be like a tingling sensation in the beginning, but there shouldn't be any burning or itching or anything. It's usually a pretty mild relaxant basically for your muscles. So I'm gonna go ahead and start looking through your scalp, okay? And if there's like a sensitive spot at any point, just let me know, okay? Doing great. Does this feel kind of good? Yeah, a lot of people like this. Good. Let me see. It's like a little bit of like flakiness on your hair, like some dandruff, dry skin. Does any of that feel painful or sensitive? Good. Good. And like right here on your hairline, it's a little bit oily, okay. And then if I kind of look down kind of by the front of your ears, it's a little bit, there's a couple breakouts as well. So we definitely need to expect that a little bit more. And then just the other side. Yeah, it's about the same. Do you by chance know your skin type? Okay, let me write that down actually. It's really good to know. And what products do you use on it by chance? Okay. Good. Okay. So I'm just gonna look a little bit closer with my light here. Just to see, yeah, definitely, yeah, I would say your T-zone, definitely needs a little bit more TLC, and then maybe on your nose a little bit too. Good. Sounds good. All right. Write that down real quick. Good. Okay. So next, I'm going to look in your ears, all right? And then just feel around and use my little light here, okay? This will be able to help me pinpoint anything that should be standing out to me. Do you have any food intolerances by chance? Okay. Or do you try to avoid any foods that you just kind of don't like in general? Just going to kind of feel around here. Yours actually look pretty good. Do you ever get like any spots inside your like earlobe right there? Okay. Good. Let me check on the other one here. Looks pretty good. Ears look really good. Nothing to really stand out on this right here. So now I'm just going to kind of move towards your face, but I want to go ahead and just put a little bit of that cream on your spots right here, okay? Okay, that should be enough for both. Okay. Good. And then put this other spot on your neck. They are painful, are they? Just in general? Okay. Perfect. Alright. So I'm gonna take my magnifying glass and my light again, so I can start looking at your face as a whole, okay? So we're just gonna look around your face. Definitely some spots. Like you said, there are oily patches. Okay. Let me just get a little bit closer here. Just to get to make sure I'm not missing anything. Good. Good. Really nice. Okay. Good. Okay. Let me just see. Good. feel your nose here. Does any of that sensitive when I push on there? I don't feel any underlying places or acne. So that's really good. What about on your chin? Do you ever get any spots around this area at any time? Where would you say in general you get your most spots? Got it. Okay. Perfect. Well, I'm gonna look a little bit closer at those spots then. With a different colored light, because sometimes under different lights, some are more harsh on your skin than others, so they can kind of reveal things that others cannot see. So I'll just kind of look around and see if there's any other spots here. What about right here? Do you get any, like, right here on your nose? Very, very infrequently. Okay. Yeah, that looks good. And what is your cleaning regimen like for your face? Okay. And how often do you use, like, body wash or soap? Alright, okay. I'm going to write that down. Perfect. Good. So next, I'm going to move on to your neck and your chest a little bit. I'm going to look at your arms and your hands, okay? I'm also going to look at your lips a little bit closer, alright? Okay, so if you could just keep them just right there. Good. Just go like it. Do you ever get, like, little cold sores or chapped lips on the side of your mouth? Okay. Right. Okay. Good. Alright. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna start feeling chest. Look on your neck a little bit. Now your neck and chest actually look really good. Besides that mole right there, I did see that you have some very slight freckles as well. Totally normal, as long as they're not changing in size dramatically or raising up too much or changing colors, you know, just moving around. You want them to stay exactly the same. See that you have just a little bit of speckly skin on the back of your arm there. Could be due to a food intolerance. So you might want to get your blood checked for that. And then let me see your hands. Nails look good. This arm also has a little bit of that speckled skin. Kind of like, looks like kind of like strawberry skin almost. Okay, good. And let me see. Good. Okay. Hands look good. This one looks really good. All right. If you could just raise both of your arms up for me. Yep. Just gonna feel your armpits here and see if there's any places. So we can finally move on and get those little spots taken care of, right? Go ahead and just start with this one, because that one sits a little bit closer to your face. Just get that one over first, right? So, just go ahead to just wipe this cream off so it makes it easier, okay? The numbness will be in effect for a few hours. Even when it comes off, it's totally fine. It's just the excess, because the rest is already soaked to your skin. Okay. So, next, I already got this nice little needle on the end here. Okay. We're just going to just start. Scab over because we are taking some part out, but that's okay, it won't feel really any pain. You probably just kind of feel some pressure. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's totally normal. Good. Okay. So let's move on to that other one. Okay, so just down here. Okay. one's a lot smaller, so it shouldn't be as bad. Should heal a lot faster. The scarring shouldn't be too bad. It might still take a couple weeks to be like almost 100%. Just because it is taking something off of your body and it needs time to heal, so it should be okay. Okay. Alright, all done with that. I'm just going to take measurements of the little area. And on this one, good. Okay, thank you. That's really good. Okay. And lastly, I just want to put on some nice healing spray. Okay. Mainly for your neck in this spot. This one's like a little topical treatment, but it also has a really nice aroma as well. Okay, so just good. Okay, perfect. So just feel right here. Okay. That looks really good. If at any point they seem to be coming back, we need to look into that further. Alright. And yeah, it will take a couple weeks still to heal. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then you did want us to do the little biopsy just in case. That will be no problem. Great. Okay, well, you are all finished. Thank you for coming in. Yes, of course. It's no problem at all. I'm happy to help. Yeah. Okay. Well, you have a beautiful day, and we'll probably hear from you soon, right? Okay, good. Well, we will see you later. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.